Hello everybody, welcome by this new YouTube clip. In this new YouTube clip, I will tell you about animals and the ability from them to predict the future. Lots of animals, you see an animal in the background here, that's the famous octopus that was predict the football, who was winning with the big football competitions worldwide. He was having it all the time good, serious, almost all the time. And also scientists and skeptici was discover that animals have psychic abilities, that they can do things that humans cannot do good. This octopus was starting, and also other octopuses and other animals are starting to be a big concurrent for the human psychics on this planet. The astrologers, people that do astrology or working with tarot cards, or try to predict, read hands and try to predict the future. These animals are much better in it, and they are very successful. This octopus was so successful that he was get bodyguards. And I'm not joking, you can read it on the internet. This animal was get bodyguards. He was get physical protection. Lots of people was having the plan to steal this octopus. There was discovered that this octopus can predict the future. Wonderful, you know, wonderful. It's animals, you see here, my big friend Tommy in the background. He's a very handsome pussycat, but he's also psychic. He can feel a lot of energies. Last time he was in my living room here and in my sleep room, and he was seeing a lot of things. He was following a lot of things, and he was seeing extraterrestrials. I was feeling it. He was extraterrestrial. He's seen extraterrestrials. He's very sensitive to me. He's a very sensitive cat also. Sometimes he's going in trance state and he sees things. He's a big friend for me, you know, and there's also another white cat. He's also a big friend of me. This is beautiful cat also, but animals are very good mediums. You have the psychics on this world, on this planet, and they try every year when the new year is coming to make predictions in spiritual magazines or in the newspaper or on television or on the internet, whatever. They try to show that they can predict the future. Sometimes things are becoming true, what they predict, but some things will not coming true. There is some things that they predict good and some things they don't predict good. But we know that animals are having a better instinct with the quantum mechanic energy, with God, than humans have. Humans think too much. And we think a lot, you know, and that blockades the intuition. Animals are very good predictors. They are very good mediums. This octopus was predict almost every time serious. 9 from the 10 time he was absolutely correct about the football. When there was a football happening in Europe, he was predict every time correct. That shows that psychic abilities exist. You know, I think that James Randi is in trouble when he see that these animals can predict really the future. What he was make a promise. He was make a promise that they was get a million, or that they was got a lot of money. That is of course a trick from him, but he will never ever give this one. He don't want that telepathic abilities exist. He don't want it, and he lie about it. He will not give it. But these animals, you know, this octopus deserve this money. You know, he deserves that he get the palace. Octopus Paul is passed over now. He's on the other side, but he was a good predictor. He was very psychic, but also other octopus are very psychic. You know, they can predict also the future, but also other animals. Pussycats are very psychic. But there is also some other interesting things. Things are happening. When I was a child, when I was, I think, 14 years old, 13 years old, or 15, I was having a little bird. We call it in the Netherlands an akkerpornis. It's a little parrot, a little parrot. I was having this parrot, and I was discovered when he was sitting in his little cage, or when I was he was sitting on the chair when he was flying around in my sleep room. When I was focused my energy on him, and I was concentrate myself on his deepest person, his brain is much more littler than my human brain. And I was have the opportunity to make contact with his deepest part of his soul. And when I was thinking then, go to sleep, he was falling in deep sleep. I was not sad, he was sleeping. And I can put him in my hand and he was sleeping. Serious. And when I was sitting before his cage and I was making contact with his deepest personality, with the deepest sense of a person in himself, that was make contact with the collective consciousness, I was get the access when he was sitting in his cage to let him drop in sleep. That shows for me that when animals, when somebody will predict the future through an animal, that the animal can get overshadowed by a spirit from out the afterlife, maybe a human spirit or maybe an extraterrestrial spirit, but a very psychic master, that going in the octopus and that canalizate his energy and give him the predictions. An animal is not thinking too much, he's feeling, he's a state of instinctive sense. You have a sort of zen state, and it's very easy to get access for some spirit when you do some positive spiritual ritual. The spirit can go in the body from the octopus, or maybe from out an external space dimension, can make contact with the octopus or with the pussycat, when the subconsciousness from the animal is allow the spirits to coming in, you know, and when it is happening with respect for the animal, they can do predictions. And I think when that animals will show a lot of skeptics also this larger reality. I show this also through my mediumship and my pictures that I make, or my readings that I give. But animals are so sensitive. We can learn a lot from animals. They feel, they are playful. They are like God's self, you know, they play, they don't know why they play. Tomorrow is not exist for them. They don't make future plans. They're living on this moment only. And that's beautiful. We must learn to go back to that sense. You know, animals feel disasters when a big earthquake is coming, or a tsunami. The animals feel it days before, and they climbing in the hills and in the mountains, and they stay there. And the people don't know, they don't feel, they work, they having fun, they watching television, they eating chips, and they have sex, and they They go to the disco, and then the tsunamis come and kill them all. And that shows that we can learn a lot from animals. Go back to nature, go back to your sense. I don't say that I'm a supporter, that I've been a supporter to misuse animals for game predictions like football or whatever, but the positive thing from it, that they have used this octopus or other animals to predict the football, who will winning, is show people, don't fuck with the spiritual nature. Don't say that psychic abilities don't exist or that life after the death not exists. You know, it's real. You see it, it's real. The octopus prove that it is real, that he can predict. And then you see also how many things are planned by the universe that we're not planning, but that things are planned by the universe. Also a game, you know, a football game. Then we think, you know, yeah, it's also quantum mechanic. It have his quantum mechanic blueprint, a sort of karma. Is also in there. It's scary for some people, but it shows that life is partly a matrix, you know. It shows that when these animals can predict this and it will happening, you know, on the millimeter, you know, on the foot, when you go with your foot to the ball, and that make or you will winning or not, if it will you make the goal. You know, but that we are also robots in that way, you know, that it will come so in this little space, you know, the energies, the quantum mechanic of influence. God is more powerful than we think, and nobody will win from God. But God loves us. We must know that, and we are here in this matrix to learn lessons. But it's fascinating when you see how things are planned, you know. Very well constructed, very well constructed. And animals are mirrors from God, and also children. They are very close to the other dimensions. And we must go back to nature, you know, go back to nature. And now on this moment, I will say to you, listen to your intuition. And when skeptics say to you that intuition not exists, please don't listen. Intuition exists. And when you listen to your intuition, everybody is having the experience that they think that somebody is popped up in the mind, popping up in your mind, some person that is living, maybe your mother or your father. And it's popped up in your mind, and then the telephone is ringing, and you pick it up, and then it's your mother or your father. What was a couple of seconds ago popping up in your mind that you must think on that person. That's telepathy between living persons. But you can have the same experience that you think out of the blue on your dead grandmother or your grandfather, or your dear friend on the other side, then it will mean that that person is around you and is thinking also on you. The first thing that is coming up in your mind most of the time, with very quick, you know, with no reason, is coming from outside. It's an external factor. It's coming from outside. It's telepathy. This you can train. It's the same as muscle training. You can train that you get contact also with spirits, guides, and with life forms in other dimensions. Your dead grandmother will not call you on the telephone. She has no muscles more. She has no body. But she is telepathic. Her energetic body make contact with you. And that will mean that she coming out of the blue up in your mind. And you can train it to see what is going interdimensional through you. But, you know, and then you can learn to communicate and listen to your intuition. Thank you that you are watching to this YouTube clip. Be good for the animals, then they are also good for you. And we are here to learn from each other. Thank you so much. See you later back in other YouTube clip, and God bless you. Bye.